Time seems to have a direction. It flows from the past into the future. However, it's not really time that makes this distinction possible. Rather, it's not actually about time at all. Interestingly though, there would come a time when the past, present and the future would all look essentially the same, and then there would be no arrow of time. The arrow of time is probably just an illusion. The direction of time that we meet on a daily basis comes from the second law of thermodynamics. Unlike what our experiences may tell, under the equations that describe our world, there's not a lot of difference between the two directions of time. Both time directions describe the world equally well. Just reverse the arrow of time and the same equations describe a world in which time is moving backwards. However, physically, we don't ever see that happening. You'll never see an egg spontaneously unbreaking itself, or liquid water spontaneously turning into ice. Why? Well, most physical laws are time symmetric, but not all of them. And there's this thing that entropy in a closed system only goes up or stays the same with time, which might be the very reason we see time moving in the direction that it does. Entropy actually measures the disorder in a system. Higher entropy implies higher disorder. What is disorder? Well, if it helps, think of it as a measure of energy spread. The more uniformly it is spread, the higher the entropy. And the higher the entropy, the less useful work can be extracted from the system. In short, energy tends to spread, implying that with time, the universe would have more and more entropy, giving us a way to distinguish the low entropy past from the high entropy future, and apparently attaching an arrow to time. However, all of this only works because the universe started off in a state of extreme order. The Big Bang gave the universe a highly ordered beginning. If the universe would have started out in a state of extreme disorder, entropy would go down as many times as it goes up, and then we wouldn't be able to attach an arrow to time. In our present universe, there's a clear trend of entropy going up with time. Reversing time reverses entropy, and so we know for sure that the early universe had really low entropy. And if we go all the way back at t equals zero, this is when the universe was most ordered. Why did the universe start off extremely ordered? Well, we don't know. But this idea goes by the name of the past hypothesis. And if we accept it that the Big Bang had really low entropy, the second law makes complete sense. Let me illustrate this with an example that I found in a book, Until the End of Time by Brian Greene. Suppose there are 100 coins placed on a table, all facing heads. This situation is akin to the highly ordered beginning of time at the Big Bang. Now, what would happen if we start shaking the table? With random fluctuations, some of the heads would flip to tails, and some of the heads that had flipped to tails may also flip back to being heads. However, because we started out with an extremely ordered arrangement of all heads, it is overwhelmingly likely that the number of tails in the table would gradually go up. Which means the system is going to get a lot more messier now. There's going to be a lot more randomness and a lot of disorder in terms of how the coins are arranged. In short, the entropy will go up. All of this can be matched perfectly with what happened with our universe. The high order of the Big Bang would have to go towards disorder, as there are many more ways of being disordered than there are of staying ordered, statistically speaking. This also highlights one of the crucial facts about the second law, and that is, it's not really true all the time. Entropy can go down by itself just by random fluctuations, much like that one coin that flipped back to being heads after it had flipped to tails. It is just unlikely that it would, because the real universe isn't composed of some hundred of particles, but rather an uncountable number of them. And so the reason an egg doesn't unbreak itself is not because it cannot, but rather it is just overwhelmingly unlikely that it would. If this is true, that the arrow of time comes directly from the tendency of the universe to get disordered, what would that imply about these occasional dips that we see in entropy? Which can happen by random fluctuations, or can also be forced in a confined region like we do in air conditioners or refrigerators. Surely time doesn't go backwards in such situations, and therefore we can reasonably conclude that the direction of time and of increasing entropy may be correlated, but they aren't the same. Now, the increase in entropy cannot go on forever. There would come a time when the universe would have reached maximum entropy. In our coin universe, it would be when there are almost equal numbers of heads and tails, and then we won't get a clear trend from order to disorder. In our universe, maximum entropy would be a universe where there is no structure, complete uniformity, and extreme cold. And so obviously this way of ending the universe is called the heat death. Heat in thermodynamics has a specific meaning, which is the energy transferred from hot to cold. At heat death, no energy gradients exist and no work can be done. But today we are not discussing this. For today, I want you to think about that moment of maximum entropy. If the only way we can attach an arrow to time is through the direction of increasing entropy, at maximum entropy, the past, present, and future would all be indistinguishable and there would be no arrow of time. But that doesn't quite mean that time would stop running. There would still be change, and for change, we need time. Without time, the universe would be an unending static, and surely, even at maximum entropy, time would exist, but without an arrow. Doesn't that kind of hint that time is sort of independent of the thermodynamic arrow of time? Time is what allows change to occur. And sure, it helps talk about it as if it flows from the past to the future. And it's okay too to use it that way. However, this is only possible because of the highly ordered beginning of time at the Big Bang. This trend from order to disorder is what allows us to differentiate the past and the future. But the moment this difference is not possible, time kind of loses its arrow. Thanks for watching. Bye.